Amen. Chapter 2, Chapter 3, 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 So we will continue with yesterday's teachings on the 37 practices of all the Bodhisattvas.
So the one that
So the 13th stanza, even if you have done nothing wrong at all, and someone still tries to take your head off, spurred by compassion, take all his or her evil into you. This is the practice of Bodhisattva. And as Ruchi stated in his commentary here, whoever takes your possession, or whoever you ask to take someone's possession on your behalf, and so when you have that sense of my belongings have been taken, do not generate that negative feeling towards that person, but rather to dedicate all your possessions or all your merits and all your negative, all your positive activities through body and mind and speech to that person.
Ganyi ge ngo jebar 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 yin na. Tertaro ge kansa tela king ge wang ge te. Dipa nam dal ne ba jase yin la ne yin. Tung hi ge kem ge wang ge. Kansa te ke dal ma yi sung ge dipa kan ge ba te tham ke te. Tene dipa nam. 나랑 길랭이 하면 되겠지. 내밖에 받겠다. 어떻게 앞에 많이.
So whoever does negative things towards you or harmful things towards you, instead of feeling resentful, generate compassion and dedicate that you are taking upon yourself all the evil that you have done, and such is the practice of the Bodhisattva.
다 안 됐다 보시나? 나는 이제 싸게 대해서 보고 다를 해서나 다 안 됐다는 게 이제 거나 말아서 가자 서서 뛰어온다고 되나 때 다시 로 마셔온다고 그러면 단내 서서 그거 깽해 그 가자 될라 단도 이나요 된 됐다고 이렇게 미세게 되니 거나 가서 보니까 Dipa kari yoba ki tamje te rangi neng niku ki honam jago wanda wate mashan waji yore la Tik ni mi ni ta te ta wo la wa yena yang ki leng to ki nipa nda wate honda so ki ki wala yon to ku mare Yon to ku mare te ta te ta wo yon mato pa yena yang Ka sa chenpo la ne pe chanchu simba tamje la ten ten te yore
So I just want to clarify, it's very difficult to generate compassion for someone who has harm upon you. So for instance, when someone cuts off your head, it's very difficult to pray for that person. But that is not the case when you are at a level of a bodhisattva. It is very, it's not that difficult to generate that kind of compassion.
Yapa tenyam, yum nepa di kumwa gawa tene kanya mare. Tena tapa lam di kubu kapsa la, tene paro di shimba kogu na, yim paro di shimba senge se la jang se di gawa. Yim paro di shimba la jang se di kapsa tene di me jen tu la. Ta tambo yunu ma to tam cha pata vina ya. Tene janem jen tu. Rūrūṅkyo gyavata vāti kyevatam kyevata, tētam mādhya vāti kyevatani, kārā sōsīv kye yelātam, tēni tāk pēnā lāvātam bēngā sōvātam, tā tētam mādhya tēni, ānyā sōsīv kye lūtāṅ tōpāṅ dāvā, pēnā jāvā tōpā sāntī chom dēntē, mēlētā pī kyevā, ngācā, mātā pī kyevā, ngācā jīpā kī kāṅ dāvā, jīnāyā, tēni kāmā, tēni tāndā, Eyula, tamu na yui jimba, tenu kanama nato, tamu bijin se me jete kumwa. O te tabu kuro, jabu ki se yena yam, tenu shendu ne kemi, keishin, toka churu ki tamu, tenu telayam kujio mambo, yopa zei yunga kapsa la, tenu tuk kemba ten hindi chimbi ki zola me tu goni, tenu sosi ki yui jimba depa la asawa, te tabu, Sākhyambhū kīśāngyō sāmbhā tāṅkīkī tētāgō nāṁ chūpū yōrē lā nāṁ mā tāṅkī mācī bhakti bhakti nā dēkē kārā pōkē kārā sēngkī kīyū lā kātū lā pēnī kōpē nā kārā rēvā lā mūmē bātēyā tā yāntā wū yōrē yāpā tāṅkī mācī tā rāñī kē kīśāngyō kī sāmbhāmbhī kī tūtō tēyā kōnē kōnē kēnē sānāṅkī tō tāṅkī Tētāvā kāṅsālā, tētāvā yīnā, lēhlā vācīdhē mātāyā, ārāntā kāṅsā sōsī, tēvāntāvā yīnā, tēgātāṁ jītī lēhlā vācī mātāyā sīnā.
So, bodhisattvas are able to generate this kind of compassion. It's not due to without any causes. It's through the practice of the six perfections, particularly in the beginning, the perfection of generosity. And here, first you start off with making offerings of your possessions or wealth, and then eventually you're able to offer your limbs, eyes, and then finally your body for the benefit of living beings. For instance, the stories of Buddha Shakyamuni, for 500 lifetimes, he was able to perform generous acts. And there is a holy site in Nepal where he actually offered his body to the tigers. And being able to generate love and compassion. So for ordinary beings, it's difficult to actually think of generating such thoughts. But it is easy for it's easy as we generate bodhicitta, and that altruistic motivation will increase over a lifetime, and it will get easier. So whoever is on this path of the bodhisattvas, whenever anyone says harmful things to you and tries to hurt you, it's always always think of praising his or her abilities, and it's very difficult when someone tries to say negative things about you to actually think of praising them or thinking kindly of that individual. So, and if one is able to do so, that is the practice of the bodhisattva.
Tell a garish in Bishiji, Kupan the boy, Yaselani, Tandeking it, said Jenna. Moment the sick gets the Tandek the sick gender, Chapa Hare or the Senna. Moment the sick gender was enough, all of Japa, the poor. And then the same day enough, all of Japa the Mayimpa, most la, than the donuts in the Himpa Jabba, the sick heavy or the thing.
So the previous stanza, we were talking about someone actually stealing your belongings, and the next stanza is talking about not just stealing, but actually attacking upon your personal self. So here, someone saying you are full of pride, you are not educated or learned. And when someone says these things, think of that individual as your precious guru. And so if you're able to think in this way, then this is the practice of the Bodhisattva.
Dāgī pūjīn kīpār tēm rūmī, dāl rā jītā vā tēnāyam, nē jītā pūpālā māyīn tō, tā pār kīpā jāsē lā rūmī. Tāṁ dā lā mūne, tā pūyō kāngcīn kī tōng lā, sāngcīn kī tēm bā tēnī, tēm bō jī tār sā rū jīn tēn lā tēnī, tēnī kēr tēnī, tā pārā kū, tāṁ bō bō lō rūm tā sō lā, マジョンドワナフェンタダニャンベセンジンダセンゴトザテニトマテハジャンゲサチョモジンメクペナタコラダシンダブギャグヨレギャグヨレテナヤタアロンバソソソドランデケジャタカガカガヨレガレパマランデケデタブヨバガレソセケダガロフンシェランデンデタブヨバ だからリクナンバーターチョコヨバリティングカスラトンとペナソシティドシェカレヨバイナヤタデタルサムデタドタンディヨレラダギクジンケバテンブミタマテケソソマタブインベケンデケダブヤダデケソシグポイエンドケバ क्या बोलते आजाद देखे तने रानी माता बोलते ये ना यारा रोबो टम्बता बोल ये ना यारों करे ये ना यारों के दाजें तो टावर के पाई ये ना चला और ते टावर टावर के पाई ये ना यां देखे जाने बसे हम कोमर के पे आजाद देखे फारो पो दाजें तो टावर के पास चला नी इताबे के कोला माइकन दो क्या माध्य तेवार के यहाँ पर जंसेन लावा की लगाया कि ताहचां के नासा दुबो की बताब जब सोचा था तो जो ये यहाँ पर ना यहाँ तनी तेला तेवार के मुझे तो ने क्यों आ के बाता तनी सेमला दोनों ना सब जो दे रहे थे तो जो ये यहाँ पर ना यहाँ देखे मैं वो पाता मुझे बिचिप नंबर ना सब जो भी ना यहाँ तनी तेला पैना ケンドネでケバちゃんはラソバテタのドグノリ。またペテジェンドラソソのセワタケバちゃんでカザ。ソヨバイナヤンテタンケラダウンテブタカレヨバイナヤン。タジャセチャンジョスメテマンメクロ。ンデクトピョンジョ。センデケブカフラ。タバテケバケバテジャセカジョスマンドラニンメセバレ。
So as vast as the universe is, there are all those many beings. And so it says that you have a mother and then you have a child. And so like the mother has the loving kindness towards their only child or towards their friends, and that if those individuals in turn treat you badly, instead of having resentment, generate caring or loving kindness towards that individual. For example, think of that individual as a very sick person. And so it would be like a mother caring for that sick only child. Such should be the kind of feeling that one should generate towards others who inflict harm upon you. And such a practice is then considered the practice of a Bodhisattva.
Rāṅtāṅ kūnyāṅmā kīpī kīvāyī mājārākvāṅgī yāsāp kēnāyā lāmā kēntu kūpē dāṅgī kīvāyīmā jāsē lālīyī tāndē lā pēnā rāṅtāṅ kūnyāṅmā kēnā sōsō tāṅ kūnyāṅmā kēnā ตาปัญญุติเจนะยินะยะโนปะราวังเจนะวังจักเจนะยินะยะโนกะเรยินะยะอะราณะยัมมิกะคังสาเจนะเจวะระนะเมมิเจวะสินะราณะมะญัมปะเตสะจะราณะกะเนนะวะนิโชนะมะวะเจวะเมมิเจวะยิงาจะระวังยิเยสะเจนะยะเจนะเจปะราณะ chimbyo na ngaje kambo yo ko to wa ni nie jo na ko to ta ni ya ta na wo ji ya ba yin na ya nie ta ye pe ki ka za de la pro pe ki go na ni de pa na so ba ma yin pa la ma yin to la ra ni ku pe ki go ni ko ni na ra ni ye jo wo number ke ba ke ni wo ni ya ta to ki ji ki number ta ko ni ko ni
So the next stanza here, even if your peers or subordinates put you down to make themselves look better, treat them respectfully as you would your teacher. Put them above you, this is a practice of Bodhisattva. So here, when you speak about peers, we're talking about peers as in terms of someone who may share the same status or same level of wealth, and subordinates would be someone who you feel are less than you. And so when they treat you badly, do not retaliate, but to generate positive attitudes towards them and to place them or treat them as if you as your teacher, and this is the practice of the Bodhisattva.
Chowen Pongshu Dab Mei Yin Tapin Neta Dung Dab Dab Yang Dab Ndok Du Dung Dab La Neng Ji Kim Kimba Nipa Yase La Neng Yin Da Yase Chanjo Simbi Ki Lam Na Shok Yase Chanjo Simbi Kyoba Su Yin Do Da Duma Sibi Kangza Din La And they send them like that. So we could go in the end, send them like that. Pongba, so we can take in. Beyond that, but never done. The mepeg tola, to tado, may yangi, near George of a shibatam. They think the la, a hajan like a tapkin, tapkin duke, natam, tapkin duke, then that would be send you the hint about that would be fantastic. ちゃんとそのラーメンショップに行けばいいやん。か、絶対と考えて、どうしてかれこうがせんな。ドッグってどんだらねんじて、たまらんでたぶけ。そう、てんてんとかに、あ、ちょっとなさとかに、せんどんじせんで、どんなことにかに、だたをならんのり。よ、絶対たんだたをてん、ほらまらんでた。 これ、今言えそうにこの見てはまんこ、さっきで出たように見えたって、運営用で。で、たぶん、よくけ、マジョンとの先生関係か、よばで関係かん、で、出たと、どんな、あれよばで関係って、誰もなんでてね、これ、出たとどんでいいと、たまると、おっさんで、てね、だ、ビルのたまると、おっさんで、見えないけばて、
So next stanza, when you're down and out, held in contempt, desperately ill and emotionally crazed, don't lose heart, take into you the suffering and negativity of all beings. This is the practice of a Bodhisattva. So an individual who is on that path of a Bodhisattva, when others harm you, take upon yourself the body, speech, and mind negativities of that individual who's inflicting harm upon you, and think to yourself that if through the negative actions of that individual's previous lifetimes that made all of these negativities ripen upon myself, and such is the practice of the Bodhisattva.
Well, that is sikki. ばあちゃんよくせん、あれでけごりせん。あ、てんでてたぶくしゃべったん。てんでげそら。たいなそそん、せんへんだちんぼよくてかすら。ちゃんよくせん、かねてにけごりせんでたすけいじんよびてんど。にゃばかしん、がまんきょうこ。なんとこいなんだたぶっちゃ。せべばんじゅんぼめでね。
So So the next stanza, even when you're famous, honored by all, and as rich as the god of wealth himself, don't be pompous, know that the magnificence of existence has no substance. This is a practice of a bodhisattva. So regardless of how people praise you and saying that you're powerful or wealthy, try not to develop pride, because as long as you're in samsara, there is no essence to all the wealth that you may enjoy at this time. And having that knowledge is the practice of bodhisattva. The next stanza, if you don't subdue the opponent inside, your own anger, although you subdue opponents outside, they just keep coming. Muster the forces of loving kindness and compassion and subdue your own mind. This is the practice of the bodhisattva. So your anger that has been with us, that has been with you from beginning this time until now, has been the cause of us wandering in samsara. So until you subdue that anger, it will continue to cause you to wander in samsara. And instead, muster the forces of loving kindness and compassion, and such is the practice of a bodhisattva.
Shechate, Lensi, the Chodanavari, Lensi, the Chosen, then it's tied to sink it and come on, you know. That what I say and come on, you know, come dig in the wall. I say and come on, you know, come dig in the wall. No money, never know what you want to do. Say, look at the lens, it's just under what it is. Tando yena ya koni kondu ka kama Ape te yendo la ta Ndoke wopo kanda kanda non kye pa yena ya Te ta to la tando nde gogundu Nde gogundu samba la sotu koni Sepa te koni kondu kyo njubu yore Te la tingi Kanda shencha kibu wopo nam Soto kare la shecha pa yena ya Te ta wu shecha kibu wopo tamji te Kato, langsung pun terus kebab di jasi kandu semangat di lani ini jenis semangat.
And the next one is sensual pleasures are like salty water. The deeper you drink, the thirstier you become. Any object that you attach to, right away you let it go. This is the practice of a bodhisattva. So for instance, pleasures such as wealth, possessions, they seem pleasurable and you want to own them or have them, and these things are like salty water. The more you drink, the more thirstier you get. So the more you possess, you will never have enough. So you're always wanting more. So whatever you're attached to, the practice should be that you let it go, and such is the practice of a bodhisattva.
Chetan nāvāṁ tathā ārāṅga saṁ, saṁ yī dhāni trāpaṁ tātā trāpaṁ, saṁ yī shēnā zhūmjīn samādhāṁ, nīlā mīdhī yāsē lādhīṁ, tāndē chetāṁ gī saṁ yī nēlū yī gōn sōṁ jōrī. Tē yīndu kāsala chetāṁ nāvāṁ tathā ārāṅga saṁ, tāṁ ārāṅsō, tāṁ kōvāla nēdhī pī kāpsala, ārāṅsō gī rītātāṁ, o tē yīndola. Che zomba tu yor nam ta che kansi yor che yoga namba tam nasim jeng namba na sabu ju koni nga nasa le shagi yor teta shawan de tam je te teni santik dorje tabu ki kub de pala teni nga nasa ke nangi yor mare teta nama de tam je te tan kowa tonga me pa ne Manato di Sengyula, Nyomu ko Marikpala teni, teni, Rangi Sengyu Chuyo pari. Chuba tila teni, teni, Daijin tu Zimba laso di, Che Yotun Zimba, Nang Sengjin tu Zimba, Ta Che Hojin di teni, Nang Kyu ki Sengjin Sengyu Sengyu Yoro, Te Tabula Zimba ko ni, Ta Kota Nuzon da Wote Kangi Sengyu Yoro Sena, Rangi Sengyu Sobu Yoro. Teta wo zogu yore te, ta teta wo zowa yena yam, ta sem de doma ni tukun tata jawa tibi. Che zon yo ten yam, sem de mduhi la ten ta zonga wo yore mato, che ro yurtu tam tuba tiyo mare la, te mepa sam de mazi, nam rangi ke sem ta wo hila cha jawa yena yam, Amo ni ye duma ni se ne hamu ni se liyori. Sem ye duma ni trupe ki tata tawa sita. Te para tawa yin matropa yopa yopa laso ki trupe ki tata tawa sita te le liyori. Te yindu kasula teya te tabi nelu yang tabi nelu manorbi nelu chupata tabi nelu kanyin bata rangi she na. Tene zonzi gisamba kaa yopanda tamki laa yela mdiji pati jase la gini yinsi mishwari.
So the next stanza, whatever arises in experience is your mind. Mind itself is free of any conceptual limitations. Know that and don't generate subject and object fixations. This is the practice of the bodhisattva. So whenever, when we are in samsara, we are making these distinctions through our mind of object and subject. From beginning this time until now, we've made these distinctions due to our ignorance. Your mind is the one that actually makes these distinctions, and knowing that they do not exist, not making those distinctions of subject and objects, that would be the practice of Bodhisattva. So when you come across something that you enjoy, though beautiful to experience, like a summer rainbow, don't take it as real. Let go of attachment. This is a practice of Bodhisattva. As one is on this path of the Bodhisattva, whatever we look at, whatever we look at that's pleasurable or pleasing, we want to possess it. Instead, look at it like a summer rainbow, where it's beautiful to look at with many colors, and but it has no substance. And similarly, when we see these pleasurable things, don't let go of it and do not have attachment for it. Such is the practice of a Bodhisattva.
Now that they can माओं पालन दिन मास माओं पालन दिन से ना दावा चल रहा था ना तो ये करना था जैसे हम तो तंग ही हो गए ते यंदो का सुना ते ने मैंने पूछे था ता मैंने ना कनांगे ता दावा चल बा संगे तो चोटन तो दाग हो जाने तंग पूछे हो बारे ते ता कड़ा चले चले ता कड़ा क्या समारे ते यंदो ता कड़ा दावा चल बा को दुपहर से ตัวชาวบ้านนี่ก็ว่าดีมากกว่าเดี๋ยวเสร็จตาตัวละคนนั้นเดมบาร์ซังอาจารย์ที่ตั้งชื่อเป็นนามว่าขันยมติคำเจตเดมบาร์ซังนะที่นี่เจ้าก็เลี้ยงขันเราได้บ่ได้ที่นี่เจ้าทองดำเนี่ยบ่เดี๋ยวดูยังเนี่ยบ่ได้บ่ได้เจ้าไปอยู่ที่เจ้าเนี่ยมันจะเจ้าเนี่ยเนี่ยบ่ขันเลยขันเลยแต่เข้าไปยังไงยัง
So all forms of suffering are like dreaming that your child has died, taking confusion as real wears you out. When you run into misfortune, look at it as confusion. This is the practice of a bodhisattva. So Rinpoche has a story of a person who was sleeping, thinking of many things. He had a bag of barley, and he hung it above his head so that the mice couldn't get to it. And then he was thinking, you know, if I make a Tibetan wine with the barley, and then I will take a bride, and then the bride's going to get pregnant, she's going to have a son, I'm going to name him Dawa Chapa. And then as he was having these thoughts, a mouse was eating the string of the barley bag that was tied up in the ceiling. The barley fell on his head and he died. So such is the story of grasping at things that are like illusions. And so the stanza says, all forms of suffering are like dreaming that your child has died, taking confusion as real wears you out. When you run into misfortune, look at it as confusion. This is the practice of a bodhisattva.
So, chukki shepar dung thakwa la ten paro bache la ten de ming mepa la ming jiba tangwa yin na ming te ki ten de pen chukki la pen na sanje ki koi kiawa tik la jabo ki ming kumye si ki koi kiawa jiba rwa teke kapsa la kien jiba nam kapsa la tamze paro bache ya ming gong su tunya ya bata wa chungwa de ten na nam sa yin na मेको पराबोल टेलीविजनना जोग्राफीले मात्र सोसला मेने पराबोला छदा इमया मेवाङ्गा तने आउ तम बताउन नउ याये तला कामै याये त टम्बाई केजोनु नउ र ओ जत्ताव माइन बच्चे केता छाजु समसा चेमबोले जोपु जिमाता मन्दे देले नया मारा सोला छमा सोसि जेवना तने ओपो जलाका देखिन दम तो याउ जोले तने ちょろもこなのペンチボタジャジョスマナのペンマゴアレでまたマランサンダゴイナモブゲタソソでタントバカレヨナヨテネテラオネレンダレワメベケトネタワイナパロトチェムクタナゴイナレテネヤコランケダネケカザアンダナデデジテワイナ माओ पाल को रपन दे दे तो जो यूं सब देखे जाओ के लते ने ते वाले ना तेरा यूं जो भी हमारे ते हिंदू का सोलता सांसे नॉट जिम बाते तो वन दे पाले ते चल ता नरान के यूं ना सब देखे रेवा में बा ते ने जिम बात तो मत के बात जैसे चाहे उस समान में डाली
If those who want to be awake have to give even their bodies. What need is there to talk about things that you simply own? Be generous, not looking for any return or result. This is the practice of a bodhisattva. So this is the beginning of the six perfections. The first perfection being the perfection of generosity. And there are different types of generosity. The first one being the generosity of material or possessions, giving away of your material goods. And here, the best generosity is the generosity of dharma through body, mind, and speech. And for instance, like the like Lord Buddha having given away his body. And here, when we make such generous offers, we do not make offerings with thoughts of suffering, but rather with joy and enthusiasm for giving. And when we give with the thought that may this, whatever you're giving, be of benefit to the receiver. And so whatever we give without any expectations of anything in return. So you give it without any attachments, without any strings attached. And so for instance,
ジャボチメコネケ。で、サンジェクノンブルジワ。ね、タバキテオナジャクタ、サンジェクタ、トクテオアキワ。ね、ジャボチメコネビジマンゴタウンジロジノレクタ、トウンダモテ。これでケンジマタウンワ。ケンジマタウンでカブラ、ハロボテライヤン。
ね、現場たまってて、もうそれから、ね、で、まあ、そういうか、ね、やんか。で、今日は、お手伝い、誕生日そばたんで、時計、本物の件ね、何件現場たまらそばたんで、キャバじゃないやん。で、カラオケは、ピンとるよ。そうそうな、で、な、リクレーションに、そうそうな、匂いのまで、こんな感じで、カラオケ、キャバと、キャンバで、
で、シェフに言わないといいんだけど。あ、てたばいいな。でね、ペダルルーター、ルーピーやらな、そこ、たんのピンとるよ。で、なんで、今、掃除機をいいな、って言って、できるようになる。で、たばいいな。掃除機をいいな、ね、パラポラマフェンなった。で、パナメルセンゲ、赤、ペダルコゾフさんの時に、ジェタを超えないな、ジマとヤンタバレイヨバ。
Yimba
Nyimba tela pa tam sadu ngar sun dide chona sambu ke lengi rewa me kati kongu rewa. Ta te ta bu chona yina nyimba yandar rewa yore.
So, sorry, I had to ask for clarification. The story of the Tibetan king Tsimikhande, he was an emanation of Buddha Shakyamuni at one time during his five lifetimes. And at that time, he had actually offered his eye, and the result of making that 500 lifetimes. And made that offering of his eye, and the recipient was able to see right away. So with the proper motivation of giving, giving without any regret, giving without any expectations, then it becomes the practice of generosity, like a bodhisattva, practice of a bodhisattva. So the recipient was able to see right away, and such should be the act of any generosity, regardless of the size or whatever you're giving. Have no expectations, have no regrets.
Gengi ke tambah sini, tak gengi ke tambah sini, nak dijawab.
So if you can't tend to your needs because you have no moral discipline, then intending to take care of the needs of others is simply a joke. Observe ethical behavior without concern for conventional existence. This is the practice of a bodhisattva. So this is the second perfection, the perfection of morality or moral discipline. Without this, one cannot accomplish your own goal. It is said that Buddha Shakyamuni, just like a parent has loving kindness towards his child, such is the feeling that Buddha has for all living beings. And so the Sangha, we have the fully ordained monks and nuns vows for that, and then the lay person, we have the various lay person precepts that we can have, and we need to abide by morality in order to attain a human rebirth. Due to moral discipline, we are able to take rebirth as humans, demigods, or gods. For instance, human beings, out of these three, human rebirth out of the demigod higher rebirths is the best rebirth to attain enlightenment. And for instance, as a lay person, we have various precepts that we can take, such as the Nune vows that one would take, the two sets, the 2 days. The Nune precepts, and then as an ordained individual or lay person, we have the Bodhisattva vows, and as a lay person, we have the lay person precepts, the precepts of the maximum being the 5, or individuals can take 4, and so forth. And so without moral discipline, if one talks about attaining enlightenment for the benefit of living beings, it's actually laughable, because without proper moral discipline, it's very difficult to achieve. So observe ethical behavior without concern for conventional existence, and this is the practice of a bodhisattva.
So tato siente ta di chenna kona chende me te paro ko bu kondo kande te la ma yena ya ene te la konze zon so ze ko kwa le nya ene wo sa la te ga ra na dong ba ma te ba yena ya ene kale kale na te la nen tok ta ba ga ba te zo te ta lo ne pe ke ko ni ene ha ta pe ke ta kande so ba kom te ba te ya se kanjo su ma na na lin yi ne ka to
If you can't tend to your needs, oh sorry, for bodhisattvas who want to be rich in virtue, a person who hurts you is a precious treasure. Cultivate patience for everyone, completely free of irritation or resentment. This is the practice of a bodhisattva. So this starts the perfection of patience. So whoever harms you should be seen like a precious jewel. Without someone causing harm and making you angry, how can one practice patience? So such individuals should be treated like a precious jewel and cultivate patience for everyone. And such is the practice of a bodhisattva.
That is the Mandela. One to tell the position in the same way. ตามนี้ก็เป็นสมณะสมณะเตยนตะตะมุตตะธรรมยังเกงงอนตะธรรมยังเกงขับปัดเจบาลาตะติโยเตมาธรรมนะนิริปตะวะยิงเกงนะงอนตะเจนตะติโยสมณะสมณะเตยตะเทกิเยสลาอะรันโดมบาหิตุเปยะนะยังงอลาเมโซโลโดตะตองทองนะ
So the next one is, the perfection of generosity, morality, and patience are the causes for taking higher, rebirth. That will be human, demigod, and god rebirth. And so the next, it says, listeners and solitary Buddhas working only for their own welfare are seen to practice as if odikuma. So the perfection of joyous effort, meditation, and wisdom are the causes for attaining enlightenment.
Then in Rawan Kantata in the Sumya Tamjigan to ता देव परा देवा ते दें दोहा ते डर ता तो लान में तो कमाल क्या बच्चा बच्चे हैं तो ता सो से चाहिए से मेरे नाम ते देव करे ये बात क्या बच्चे बच्चे देता भी ता परा समझे समझे लफ़ेंद लान में बंदे होंगे ये चीज़ ये दोने देता वो समझ दे पाला
Listeners and solitary Buddhas working only for their own welfare are seen to practice as if their heads were on fire. To help all beings pour your energy into practice is the source of all abilities. This is the practice of a bodhisattva. So the next perfection is joyous effect, joyous effort, the perfection of joyful effort. Whenever we practice, so here the example here, are listeners and solitary Buddhas working only for their own welfare are seen to practice as if their heads were on fire. So for instance, if their heads were on fire, they would only be concerned about putting out the fire on their heads and not think about other things. Whereas a bodhisattva would be thinking on behalf of all living beings and not be concerned for themselves. So with that kind of motivation and thought, this is the practice of a bodhisattva.
Sine rabdi dhebe hanho ke namo namar jomba she se ne zami ke le yanda nda wali samdhen kamba jase rangi ta te yesu la ta samdhen la kawali jela chine rabdi dhebe hanho ke ta gom singe te ते तने रंगीन विषने चपात पापन दोस्तों दोस्तों को विषने सामुवादन दार्श कोना विषने चपात की तने कोम्या योरी ते कोम्या के काउसला तने बेचें तो लो रंगीन विषने यहाँ तक आते हैं वो योग की जंजे से लगते हैं ना कि ने लोग तोड़ डालो मोसला कि शर्मनाक डालो तोड़नाक हाँ नौ यूं जैसे सो जो इतिहास लगे ना तब नौ मंदिर नंबर तो बातें जमर के बातें हम तेरा उन जमर के बातें सो जो हाँ पावर के ने ज़मीन के ने यंदा दवाई तब ना ज़मीन पर ये के ने लम्बे वाले ज़मीन पर ये ले यंदा दवाई समथिंग को मज़ासे लाने से निकाल Understanding that emotional reactions are dismantled by insight supported by stillness, cultivate meditative stability that passes right by the four formless states. This is the practice of a bodhisattva. Here, the sixth perfection is the perfection of meditation. It's important to the calm abiding.
Calm abiding meditation. One must engage in the calm abiding meditation first, because our minds are so busy with lots of doubts and thoughts. It's similar to like a boiling water. So if you pour a cup of cold water, then it would calm it down. And such would be the effect of engaging in calm abiding meditation. And then due to the strong calm abiding state, then one is able to develop vipassana. Oh, one is able to engage in vipassana meditation, and then on to meditative able to cultivate meditative stability. And so I'll repeat the last two words here. Cultivate meditative stability that passes right by the four formless states. This is the practice of a bodhisattva.
Kata mepe, kata chingayi, dhobhi chanjur, kapa mejirwe, tabdham nengin, kosham meto, kata goma jase rani ni, ta tamatela, kata bupharo dikhema, sangma de. Ta kata bupharo dikhema, de kata bupharo dikhema, dhok, sen, siyo rete, yenaya onegi, yimba, chutum, dhopa, tundu, something so bad that shut up the ghost. Shut up the boy, you nick on the thinner. Shut up the touch, shut up number, you shut up thinner. Nello, young topic, don't talk with you, shut up. There's only half way up, shut up. Say, in the castle of Ben and Jimma, now what you in I am. Then a young topic that something not the Jimma in I am. Yam tabu di jimba ki gohu yuwa mato, pena, sanfi no di jimba ti, pena wo di cha gya pa yin na, tam me ti ka panjo shendo, ne de chenpo yuwa ti. Ka panjo chenpo yuwa ti ki, no ne, menda sanfi ngu sota chenpo ti la, tani, chewa nisam je pe yama tabu yin na, di shirap ta mi jimba yi. Shut up the Mazin to Jim Paro to Chimba Jimba Dana Dogama. Jimba Dog, it is in Jimba Dog. Minimum, what you are. That take a letter, cut it to the center, tiny men that is the name, Sure, young Dava took the long palmer, the so palmer, Ganyan, so from the song, the Shepard and Pagota, Shepard and Demana, the Mumu Rella, or Tamara, the Messer, Lava Jasam was it over the beginning, young but the children the song, that the children is the Nathanum, when the song got the Punjabi, the children. Then I am that the Lava Jasin, that the young Dava, the children. The name, but I paddled the chimney around the dog, it is enough, then I brought to my body. All taken the last Zopa, that would kill the Yenayan. The name, but I bet that I'm dead to pick up that would be enough. The name, but I yell out the Yenayan. The name, really, I may not tell you something that was up, but I send the tower here to pick up the last. So you put the gave on the man, yeah. So the big kid, the day, the country, my dog, I say, come on, yeah. Zip to a theater, we could spend a time, but I'm some big chimble could go on the theater with over your name. Then the day, that will be that, then somebody wants to go over come here then. The young tap with the swap out, the young tap with the children, the young tap with the gym of men with the kid, now. Then the day, that will Yamba Yanta by Yimin, Sutum Yanta by Yimin, or that the Zoba Yanta by Yimin, the ship again, then they shut up the gold. They shut up the Chetan, the Maha that they shut up the Yoko.
Without wisdom, the five perfections are not enough to attain full awakening. Cultivate wisdom endowed with skill and free from the three domains. This is the practice of a bodhisattva. So the perfection of generosity, morality, patience, joyous effort, and meditation, if they're not conjoined with wisdom, it would not be enough to attain full awakening. So the you need wisdom, for instance, the example of generosity. So let's say you were to give millions of dollars to a person who's very rich, to a person who happens to be a gun manufacturer. The act of generosity has been done, but without the wisdom, knowing what that person was going to do, it does not become the act of generosity that that is enough to attain full awakening. So it is important to have wisdom conjoined with all five previous perfections for it to be considered the six perfections to attain full awakening. So it says that without the wisdom, these five perfections, the perfection of generosity, morality, patience, choice, effort, and meditation, is like the perfections without the eye. So here it says, without the wisdom, the five previous perfections would not then be the causes to attain full awakening. So with the five perfections and the wisdom, you've got the method and the wisdom to attain full enlightenment. And the three from the three domains. So here, when we talk about the and free from the three domains being the giver, the act the person giving and the thing that is being given and the receiver. And when we say free from the three domains, is free from thinking that these three domains are inherently existing. So if you don't go into your own confusion, you may just be a materialist in practitioner's clothing. Constantly go into your own confusion and put an end to it. This is the practice of a bodhisattva. So it is said by one of our great Tibetan masters, Jambu Kundurumche, said that if, let's say, you have your faults as big as a mountain and you try to hide it, and then you see a small fault in an individual, small as a minute particle, but then you make a big thing out of it and start spreading words about that individual's faults. And so it's very important, rather, to, through your own mind, investigate what are the positive things that you're doing and what are the negative acts that you're doing. So it's very important for you to police your own mind. And so it is said that in the stanza when it says practitioner's clothing, so with the name of a practitioner, but if you're going around pointing other people's faults, then you're not truly a practitioner. And so it's important to always check your mind, constantly go into your own confusion and put an end to it. And this is the practice of a bodhisattva.
No more one, just say, hint, okay? Nepali na dani nyamdurbe. Chipa chela chopu kaza ki nipa mina gazela ni. Ta nyomo wangsi is. Ta sozo chenda nete nyomo ba chewa. Ta mbaja cheta tumo majer. Ta do kudeshi la sope te ta nyomo ba chindu to wangsi. Tene javu sepo paro po tanto la. Ne adale ne bande ta yore de ki chatan de tu ja ke yore de ke le kan de tu ja le ki yore de ke ke dan de tu ja ke yore se ba ta ni ne pa le ne le ma te pa ni na ta te ta ni pa ti ka te ni na la de pa ni na da ni ne ba ni yo pa ro po le ni pa la pa te ke pa ro po le ko ka ni mu ma le so se de te ni ta ยาเจนเตเตเตเนติปาติยาพอนะคุณเป็นตัวที่
You undermine yourself when you react emotionally and grumble about the imperfections of other bodhisattvas, of the imperfections of those who have entered the great way. Don't say anything. This is the practice of a bodhisattva. So due to the power of our negative emotions, such as anger, attachment, and ignorance, you tend to point out the faults of others. It doesn't hurt the other person, but rather it diminishes your good qualities and creates negative karma for oneself. And so by not saying anything and not pointing out others' negativities, this would be the practice of a bodhisattva.
Nikorwangi pensi tomu, that nipa the quarters in the day. Pemasi paki, no cover the other thing, and nipa the quarters in the day, mambo, joina. And that on that in Yopaina, that nipa the quarter, jade Yopaina, and they kill a day with the chest around our tail, the trunk around our tail, and they cover your body. That I will cover joina, that is the pendula.
When you squabble with others about status and rewards, you undermine learning, reflection, and meditation. Let go of any investment in your family circle or the circle of those who support you. This is a practice of a bodhisattva. And here, when we talk about, arguing actually about what rewards others are receiving, how much more they're receiving, and just focusing on those kind of things, we're wasting a lot of time that you've taken away from the learning, reflection, and meditation. And so all similarly, if you invest too much time to your family circle, you've actually taken more time away from your learning, reflection, and meditation. So let go of any investment in your family circle or the circle of those who support you, and then this would be the practice of a bodhisattva.
Tum take a cutting over the center, and sit to go to tower, you know. The game part of God, same day, go no day. That's not the one, the tone of the game. Then I can announce a girl at Tambi Yorba. Tom, not long as me, and the same to look up to the other day. Tom, the last, then there was nobody on my day. Then I am sit to go to cut up all around now.
Abusive language upsets others and undermines the ethics of a bodhisattva. So don't upset people or speak abusively. This is the practice of a bodhisattva. So when you use harsh language or abusive language, it disturbs the others' minds. There's a saying in Tibet, abusive language has no sharp edges, but it has the ability to cut your mind.
Pieces.
Cut your mind into pieces. And also, when we say such things as, oh, he's a very good lama, but you just can't really listen to him, and that undermines the practice of a bodhisattva. So don't upset people or speak abusively. This is the practice of a bodhisattva.
Mamma, no more but it wonder shoyala let have no more but it than Ricona can it than heaven over today. No more the comes from us comes and get the better man out of the good thumping of it. Then come the power in the good and mind of your money. Come and let have him and of it in the book of hand. Tambo, Jewatan, then Hakoa Zone, तेने सांझा के करे इना तो बता दूला तेने न्यानो तंबो के वाने तेमा था दूला या वो बोले बोले वाने ना रंसा मान जंग तो बच्चे बच्चे जाते तेंजो ते मतलब लाने में भी पाते
When reactive emotions acquire momentum, it's hard to make remedies work. A person in attention wields remedies like weapons, crushing reactive emotions such as craving. As soon as they arise, this is the practice of a bodhisattva. Negative emotions, it's very easy to fall under the power of negative emotions due to our conditioning. So it is said that through conditioning or getting used to or by being trained, it's easy to do anything. For instance, making clay pots. After a while, you can make these clay pots without even looking at the wheel or what is it, the turntable, right? That makes the pots go round. So you can actually accurately make pots without even looking at the instrument that makes it. And in Tibet, we have shepherds who take slingshots, and so they can accurately put a stone in the slingshot. I think it's called slingshot, Tibetan slingshot.
Mm-hmm.
And they can actually hit their targets. And similarly, with proper training and conditioning, we are able to recognize negative emotions when they arise, recognize it, and be able to cut it down. And being able to do that will be the practice of a bodhisattva. So in short, in everything you do, know what is happening in your mind. By being constantly present and aware, you bring about what helps others. This is the practice of bodhisattva. So here, in summary, whatever you do through body, mind, and speech, always or constantly check your mental attitude or your motivation. So constantly check your attitude or motivation when you're engaged in any activities, and such is the practice of the bodhisattva.
Jembar cakap dia lah sokudun tu sih, mereka pasal nampak tak pun tu sih.
So then this brings us to the final stanza of the text. To dispel this which is dedication. So to dispel the suffering of beings without limit, with wisdom freed from the three spheres, direct all the goodness generated by these efforts to awakening. This is the practice of a bodhisattva. So here, may all the merits created through this go through dispelling the sufferings and causes of sufferings for all living beings. So this will conclude the teachings, and then we will do our dedication prayers.
Amen.